Space is the place.
Space is indeed the place. During the civil rights struggle of the 1960s, a concurrent revolution in jazz was taking place. This was a revolution where jazz artists challenged assumptions of harmonic and rhythmic structure and forged ahead into a new territory of music with new values. Because this music threatened the status quo, many critics and theorists associated it with the socio-political turmoil and upheaval that was taking place at the same time. These same critics made a connection between musical experiments that involved frenetic and loud playing and the militant, angry, and sometimes violent expressions of the civil rights organizations like the Black Panther Party and Nation of Islam. Some jazz musicians and sympathetic literary figures fueled this association by avowing that their aims were in keeping with Black Marxists and other supporters of the Black Power movement. Artists such as Archie Shepp, Bill Dixon, and Amiri Baraka were among the most vocal in their corroboration of these connections. As the history of the free jazz of the 1960s and 1970s is written, this relationship between the Black Power movement and the jazz revolution gets by far the most attention. There were, however, other perspectives and proposed solutions to the civil rights question that post-Cold War America faced. Three of the most significant figures in the free jazz revolution of the 1960s and 1970s, Sun Ra, Anthony Braxton, and John Coltrane, were specific in their presentation of a solution that was decidedly not in keeping with the radical and militant expressions of the Black Power movement, even if their musical searching reached a level of freneticism that led some to consider the music aggressive and angry. These three artists, each in their own unique manner, presented at least quasi-utopian solutions to the issue of racial conflict in America through constructs of different vestiges of space. In the work of Sun Ra, who presented outer space as the home of idyllic new worlds where racial strife no longer existed. In the work of John Coltrane, who modeled spiritual explorations of the inner space of meditation and the metaphysical world as a refuge from social turmoil. And in the science-based synesthetic work of Anthony Braxton, who throughout his career used a combination of the two in presenting his views on the requisite changes in humankind's value systems that he saw as the core of Western society's dysfunction, as evidenced by the racial conflicts of the 1960s. These three artists are the focus of my research, which resulted in a document called Change is Where You Find It, Constructs in Astrophysics and Metaphysics in the Jazz Revolution of the 1960s and 1970s.